Hi, this is Richard, and welcome to another edition of Sidewalks Entertainment. Lori welcomes back a previous guest who hasn't been on our show, hard to believe, since 2000.
Hi, thank you so much for tuning in to Sidewalks Entertainment. You are in for a treat because today's guest is considered the fifth most played female artist on country music radio, and she's a multi-platinum artist too. Today she's going to be joining us to talk a little bit about her tour, her music, and so much more. Sarah Evans will be joining us right here on Sidewalks Entertainment, so stick around. You don't want to miss out because you're watching Sidewalks Entertainment. I'd like to welcome multi-platinum country music artist Sarah Evans to Sidewalks Entertainment. Hi, Sarah. Thank you so much for joining us.
Hi, how are you?
Well, I am doing fantastic. I am so excited to have you on our show today because the last time we had you on our show was like 8 albums ago. So we have a lot of catching up to do.
Yes, we do.
Yeah, well, you were promoting your album Born to Fly, which belated congrats, by the way, because you won the Video of the Year award for the single of the same name. So, yeah, it's been a while.
Wow. That has been a long time ago. A lot has happened since then.
Well, you're considered the fifth most played female artist on country radio in the last 20 years. What are your thoughts on that?
Oh, I think it's wonderful. I mean, you know, having a hit at country radio is the thing that makes the wheels turn, you know, so you always want, you know, to be able to be heard on country radio and have even, you know, always have your new music be played on country radio as well. So, it's been incredible. I mean, I've had an opportunity to have, you know, so many hits out there and, thanks to the fans and thanks to country radio. So, I love that. I wish I was the first most played, but being the fifth most played is fine.
Yeah, well, I mean, even being the fifth, I mean, that is such a huge accomplishment.
Yeah, it is. I know. I'm kidding. It's such an honor.
So you've been creating music and topping the charts for years. What's it like it when you hear your music on the radio? And not just your new songs, but like songs that you've written years ago as well.
Oh, it's great. It's everything that you, it's the whole reason for doing what we do. And I never take advantage of it. I never like skip. I'm always like, you know, I'm going to leave it on the station. I'm gonna listen to the whole song because, you know, every single time I'm so grateful to God for,
do you ever sing along to your music when you hear it on the radio?
You know, I don't remember. I usually don't sing unless I'm on stage because I'm always trying to save my voice. But then again, I probably do. I don't know.
Oh, I love that. So you probably do it without even realizing it, huh?
Yes.
So tell me about your album Unbroke and where did your inspiration come from for this album?
Well, I co-wrote 10 out of the 11 songs and, it started out just being an album because when I started writing the album, I was separated from my husband and we were going through a really rough patch. And so the songs were very sad. They were very, you know, depressing and also, but also really good and really country. And then about halfway through the making of the album, I would say, I'm so bad about timelines, but we started talking again and we started, you know, getting back together and going to counseling and doing all this stuff. So then I started writing more happy songs. And so 21 days is kind of in between, you know, it's like, could I go 21 days, you know, without talking to somebody that I love? And I found out the answer is no. I could not, you know, not be with my husband. And so we just decided to do everything to make it work. So 21 days ended up being kind of more on the light side of things with the album, but it really goes all over the place emotionally. It's sad, it's happy. It talks about, you know, a lot of deep issues that, you know, that aren't just about, you know, trucks and boots and beer. And it's, you know, there's a lot of depth.
It's very personal.
Yeah.
Yeah. And learning the backstory of your album, that got me a little bit emotional. That's so beautiful.
Aww.
So when you made this album, which song did you anticipate would be really fun to perform on stage?
I don't know that I think about that. Like, you know, this one's going to be, because you never really know till you try it. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you'll think, oh, this is a cover tune that we want to try. And then we get up there and we realize this is not working. It's not my vibe. It's not matching with who I am. Mm-hmm. But 21 days, I knew, and I'm not just saying that because it's the new single, but I knew that it was going to be really fun to perform. And there's another song on there called Sorry Now, which is like a rocker. It kind of sounds a little bit like Heart and or like Daisy Jones and the Six. And we do that. And then we do Pride. Those are the three new ones that we're performing at the moment in the live shows.
Nice. That's fantastic. Well, Sarah, it really was such a pleasure to speak with you today. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you very much. It was so nice to talk to you.
Everyone, you can listen to Sarah Evans' music at www.melodyplace.com and be sure to also check out her tour dates at www.sarahevans.com. She might be performing very soon at a city near you. Sarah, it really was such an honor to speak with you today. Thank you again.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me. Have a great day.
For more full-length celebrity interviews, visit us at SidewalksTV.com, our YouTube channel, and don't forget to follow us on social media.